This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday, the 7th of March. I'm Georgina White. Three locals charged with port murder. Minister Linares visits youth centres. RGP warn of computer scam. Murder inquiry ends without arrest. Opposition publish parliament questions. RGP launch recruitment campaign. And finally, 6th of March lottery results. Three local men have been charged with murdering a security guard in Gibraltar's port in 2008. Jeffrey Lewis, aged 59, died in October last year, 3 years after suffering head injuries during the alleged robbery of a cigarette container at the North Mole. The men were charged jointly last night by the Royal Gibraltar Police and remained in custody at New Mole House. Christian Lawer, aged 33, of Rosedale, Anthony Lombard, aged 36, of Gavino's Dwelling, and Shane Ritchie, aged 25, of Gardiner's Road, appeared before the Magistrates' Court today. Minister for Youth, Mr. Stephen Linares, visited all four of Gibraltar's youth clubs. Mr. Linares commenced his visit at the youth club at Montague Bastion. He then went on to the Dolphins Youth Club, the Plata Youth Centre, and finally the Laguna Youth Club. Members of the clubs shared their views with the minister and asked questions on the future of their club. The youth service is always looking for volunteers to help out with the local youth centre. The Royal Gibraltar Police have received a number of complaints from members of the general public complaining about a computer scam being tried in Gibraltar via telephone calls to certain individuals. The scam works by criminals posing as computer security engineers and calling people at home to tell them that they are at risk of a computer security threat. The scammers tell their victims they are providing free security checks and add authenticity by claiming to represent legitimate companies and using telephone directories to refer to their victims by name. Once they have tricked their victims into believing they have a problem and that the caller can help, the scammers are believed to run through a range of deception techniques designed to steal money. The RGP have discontinued the murder investigation into the death of a woman in the area of Cumberland Road 2 years ago, as they cannot take the case any further, as detectives have not been able to gather sufficient evidence to bring charges. Beverly Campbell, aged 52, sustained a fatal knife wound and died in her home in July 2010. An investigation was opened and a man was arrested after a knife was found near the property. The evidence proved inconclusive. Coroner Charles Beadle must now convene an inquest to assess evidence and reach a conclusion. The GST have published Shadow Minister for Tourism, the Port, the Airport Traffic and Transport, Damon Bosino's questions for March's Parliament session. Mr. Bosino will be questioning the government on whether the bus company received an illegal advice before dropping the defence of the unfair dismissal claim by Mr. Sardegna against the company. Mr. Bosino will also be seeking information as to whether the position of Chief Executive Officer for the new terminal had been filled. This afternoon saw the RGP launch a recruitment campaign to help individuals to apply for the force. As part of the application process, successful candidates will be invited to attend a selection weekend to be held on the 12th and 13th of May, where their sustainability will be assessed. YGTV spoke to two of the RGP's recent recruits.
Thank you for speaking to us at YGTV. Why did you decide to become recruits of the force?
It's something that I've always wanted to do, and I tried to join 10 years ago, and the structure of joining the police was different at that time, and sadly I failed the maths exam. But then 10 years later I decided to try again, and I think it's the best thing that I've done.
For me, living in London, I came to Gibraltar mainly for safety reasons, and I wanted to help to try and maintain the safety within the community. Also, I believe I could help the Royal Gibraltar Police Force with the skills I possess.
And finally, last night's lottery draw saw ticket number 06440 win the first prize of £100,000. Ticket number 19419 won the second prize of £10,000, and ticket number 11230 won the third prize of £5,000. For all of the minor prizes, check out our website at yourgibraltartv.com. That's a YGTV News. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.